Senator Saviello, Representative Tucker, and members of the Environmental and Natural Resources Committee. My name is Gail Maynard. I am an organic beef producer from Aroostook County. My family operates Orchard Hill Farm in Woodland. I am here to testify in opposition to LD 395 and in support of LD 820, if amended. While my comments focus on Aroostook County, where I live and have a business, my concerns would extend to wherever there are mineral deposits and mining interests throughout the state. On May 3rd, 2012, I attended a presentation in Fort Kent where J.D. Irving, Canadian head of J.D. Irving Limited, rolled out his proposal for an open pit mine at Bald Mountain. In the ensuing 5 years, I have researched this topic extensively. Initially, I thought mining might be an answer to the economic woes of our area. My research has, however, only exacerbated my fears. Mining is one of the dirtiest industries in the world, and the environmental track record of mining companies is dismal. Mining in areas of high sulfide deposits and arsenic concentrations, such as those at Bald Mountain, would endanger sustainable economic activity, wildlife habitat, and quality of life. I am also concerned about inflated claims of mine-related jobs. There is no promised job in the world worth the destruction of Aroostook County as we know it. I urge you to oppose LD 395, the weakened rules proposed by the BEP, despite overwhelming public opposition. These rules are unacceptable. They do not protect us. I am persuaded that open pit mining cannot be done at Bald Mountain without substantial and unquantifiable risk to water quality and wildlife habitat. Once acid mine drainage occurs, it cannot be corrected. For any of you who have enjoyed the beauty of public lands like Dabuli, I ask you to imagine how it might appear as a Superfund site. In addition, I urge you to support LD 820 to include a ban on wet mine waste management and pit mines. It's not a perfect bill, but it addresses many of my concerns: protection of water quality, public lands, and Maine taxpayers. I also support a total ban on open pit mining in any area of the state presenting the geologic and climatic conditions found at Bald Mountain. Please have the courage to confront corporate interests and big money. Vote to protect and maintain this pristine corner of Aroostook County. Open pit mining should never happen here. Clean water is everything. Folks will long remember if this legislature sacrifices our quality of life for a fool's gold promise of short-term jobs. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Senator Saviello, Representative Tucker, and members of the Joint Standing Committee on the Environment and Natural Resources. My name is Shelley Mountain. I live in Mapleton in Aroostook County. I'm from Portage Lake on the Fish River chain, and I own a camp there. I'm here again to ask you to do more to protect Maine waters from the inevitable water contamination that accompanies all mining operations. None of these bills does that. Some make a little effort to pretend they are doing that, but they are not. I have lost track of how many times I have been here about this same issue, but I do know that every time I have, the overwhelming majority of testifiers have made it clear to you that they do not want to allow any contamination from mining. I have not heard testimony that the majority of Mainers are willing to allow even a little bit of contamination. The very healthy environment of northern Maine provides sustainable job opportunities in forestry, tourism, and agriculture. Those industries would be destroyed if you allow any environmental contamination from mining. There are no bills offered that would prohibit companies or their subsidiaries with a history of environmental violations to be permitted. Irving has a history of violating environmental law. There is nothing in any of these bills that prioritizes the employment of Mainers in mining. During public forums, Irving has admitted that they would not be hiring Maine people for the good-paying, skilled jobs. They would likely be filled from out of state and out of country. I am incredibly frustrated by the amount of energy and personal resources I have spent to continue to come down here to repeat the same things over and over again. Although mining rules will affect the whole state, the original 2011 bill was prompted by the prospect of mining Bald Mountain and Aroostook. Not once has there been a hearing held in Aroostook. The onus is always on Aroostook citizens. I'm counting in my head 18 people from Aroostook opposing this here today. The onus is always on Aroostook citizens to trek down here, and when they do, their concerns are ignored in favor of the concerns of environmental and industry lobbyists. I am frustrated by the amount of state resources that have been wasted on trying to shove bad mining rules down the throats of Maine citizens. Imagine if the state put this kind of energy and resources into increasing forestry and agricultural opportunities in Aroostook. My 22-year-old son is a log hauler like my husband. I want this legislature to be doing more to ensure that he has opportunities that will allow him to stay. Bills that allow contamination will do just the opposite. There is much agreement that agriculture is the future for Aroostook. I want this legislature to be doing more to increase opportunities that will attract young farmers to come to Aroostook. None of these laws will protect or increase opportunities for young people we are losing. Thank you. I've attached links about Irving's environmental violations and also links about the Presteele Stream. In the 1960s, good-intentioned environmentalists allowed the contamination of the Presteele Stream in favor of jobs, and it was a disaster. And I've heard a lot of the legislators say they would support a ban on open pit mining. Why didn't anybody introduce that bill? Thank you.
Questions?
Good morning to the committee. My name is Jane Caulfield. I'm from Presque Isle, Maine. I worked in economic development for 15 years, first with the Northern Maine Development Commission and later with the Aroostook Band of Mi'kmaqs. I am a non-native that shares the same worldview as the Mi'kmaqs, which is that we should use what we need from the earth, but remember future generations. J.D. Irving claims that mining Bald Mountain would create in the range of 700 direct or indirect jobs in northern Maine. However, companies usually overpromise job creation and underestimate environmental risk when convincing people to help them establish themselves in a community. In the 1990s, when I was inventorying local economic development projects, Boliden of Sweden estimated that they would create 80 to 100 jobs, a fraction of what Irving promises now. You can expect even fewer short-lived jobs for our local people. Boliden also found that mining Bald Mountain is a particularly dangerous activity there because the ore is so reactive that it would be impossible to avoid contaminating ground and surface water. It is possible that the value of the ore they extract will never be able to cover the cost of decades of cleanup. Historically, mining companies come in not only with big promises, but take what they want, then leave behind a toxic mess that taxpayers are left to clean up. And even with prepayment of the company in attempting that cleanup, the effort will never fully restore such a precious natural resource. When weighing risks and benefits, any weakening of mining regulations is a bad decision for Northern Maine. Thank you.
Senator Sabiello, Representative Ralph Tucker, members of the Environment and Natural Resources Committee, I thank you for this opportunity to testify. My name is Alice Bolstridge. I'm from Presque Isle, Maine. Since 2012, I've taken months at a time to research metal mining in preparation for testifying here. Four times now I've done it, since I also came down in September to testify before the Board of Environmental Protection. I know from all this research that Bald Mountain is among the most toxic sites in the United States. A man who worked there on the original exploration of the site in the 1970s called me to talk about a fellow worker who became sick just from the dust of the drilling holes. He broke out in a rash so severe he had to be taken to the emergency room for treatment. I've heard testimony at previous hearings, and I'm hearing it again today, from medical people, from medical doctors, about serious medical effects of open pit mining, effects which sound deadly to me. I know from research that the geologist who discovered and explored the Bald Mountain site, John S. Cummings, found arsenic levels, and I'm quoting here, arsenic levels in the rock up to 2.9 million times the level the Federal Environmental Protection Agency considers safe for drinking water. In one of his many writings about the mountain, Cummings describes the site as an enormous, naturally occurring toxic dump. In a letter to John Martin in 2012, Cummings said, a large open pit mine is a prescription for a debacle. According to a 2014 industry article that analyzes risks to be managed to increase profitability, the metal mining, and I'm quoting again, the metal mining industry is the largest toxic polluter in the United States. In addition to water pollution, it is a significant contributor of greenhouse emissions and other hazardous air pollutants that have more localized but significant human health and environmental impacts. This pro-mining article talks about managing the risks. It makes no claims about preventing toxic effects. I've found no convincing evidence in research or testimony since 2012 that pollution of groundwater and toxic waste can be safely contained in perpetuity at sites like Bald Mountain. For all these reasons, I can only support a ban on open pit metal mining or on any underground mine that poses unacceptable risks to water, air, soil, and human health, and sustainable socioeconomic health of communities. Mining at the Bald Mountain site and other toxic sites in Maine must never be allowed unless or until trustworthy evidence exists that it will be done without risk of catastrophic damage. That evidence, as far as I know, does not exist at this time. And I invite any of you, please, if I'm wrong about this, if you do have evidence that I haven't been able to find, my email is at the top of the testimony. Please email me and tell me. I've made comments about each of the bills on another page and more quotations from the industry site. Thank you again.
Thank you. Questions?
Senator Saviello, Representative Tucker, members of the committee. My name is Sarah LeClaire. I'm an attorney in Presque Isle. My home in Woodland is, I've learned this morning, less than 35 miles from Bald Mountain. I'm the daughter of a World War II hero, Silver Star winner, who survived the horrors of the South Pacific, lost a leg, came back and succumbed to toxic poisoning in an industry in Massachusetts at a very young age. What I speak today about is not so much science, but the consideration of our place in the generational view that you owe to the people that come after us. 10 years ago, I bought and rehabbed a commercial building on Main Street in Presque Isle, a leap of faith. It's now home to two successful businesses that provide good-paying jobs. I am a financial stakeholder in Aroostook County. I am struck in this debate by the arrogant and incorrect belief that our lives are somehow more important than those of the generations of Mainers who will live after us. Whether you believe in creation through God or nature, the masterpiece of the Fish River chain flowing through northern Aroostook County is an irreplaceable treasure that inspires us, renews us, and makes our lives worth more. It makes our lives worth more. Bald Mountain exists in a water-rich location at the very confluence of the Fish River chain. Mining in that location with the technologies of today would be an amoral, and ugly theft from all of the generations of Mainers who come after us. The mining of Bald Mountain is not within our generation's legitimate technical ability. Therefore, it's not within our generation's right at all. Aroostook County's future does not lie in the toxic tailings of open pit mining. Our future lies in the guarantee of clean water, an ever rarer life and recreational resource that Mainers of today are morally obligated to preserve for the future. I'm here to support legislation only that prohibits open pit mining, prohibits wet waste management, prohibits containment ponds, and the contamination of ground and surface waters by any mining operation. Let Maine lead, please, by demanding mining technology that does not sacrifice our health, lakes, air, rivers, and groundwater. Maine must lead by demanding that any mining be conducted in a manner that does not saddle future generations. We're old. We're moving on. Don't saddle future generations of Mainers with a toxic legacy. The hopelessness that many young people feel about the environment we're leaving them is frankly heartbreaking. And I ask you to consider them.
Thank you. Questions? Thank you. Brian?
Good morning.
Morning, Brian.
Members of the committee, my name is Brian Brissett. I was born and raised in Stockholm, Maine, and have spent a large amount of my time in the woods and wilds of Aroostook County. I'm not good at this, just so
you're
you know.
You're doing fine.
That's all right. All right.
No problem. I won't let Ralph bite at you.
Oh, so good, right. Good,
you're
good,
good.
You're all set. Actually, mine is a lot lighter than a lot of these.
I promise you that Ralph will be good. He's promised, right, Ralph? See, so you're all set.
I am also a business owner in Presque Isle. I have two sons, two grandchildren, and live in Presque Isle with my wife of 37 years. Who's going to bite? Huh?
You're good.
Okay. I caught my first brook trout when I was 5 years old. I'm not good at this. And I have been fishing ever since. One thing brook trout and I need is clean water, as does everyone in Aroostook County. I have taken my time today and come all this way to express as strongly as I can how opposed I am to the mining of Bald Mountain. I'm almost done.
You're good. You're doing great.
All right.
You're doing great.
I've taken wounded veterans, people over 80, one lady that was 91, children.
You're doing great.
Yep.
You're fine. You're doing
recovering
great.
Addicts, brook trout fishing. And I want the native brook trout here for my children and their children. Maine has 97%. That's a very large number of the nation's native brook trout. It's important to me, and I don't care about listening to the minimizing of the risks, the exaggeration of the benefits of mining. The arsenic, sulfuric acid, and other toxins need to stay in the ground.
You're good.
One more sentence.
You got it.
The mining rules need to be strengthened to assure clean water in Aroostook for all time.
Super job. Very good.
Wait, any wait, questions? Wait, anybody wait, want
wait,
to go
wait,
fishing?
No, wait, no. You take old people fishing?
I'll take anybody. All right.
Thank you very much, bro.
Good morning, Senator DeSalvio, Representative Tucker, distinguished members of the committee. I'm Bob Dorsey.
Shh. Please.
I'm the president of the Aroostook Partnership, and I represent about 100 companies, and our mission is to promote economic development in Aroostook. I'm testifying in support of LD 580 to enable mining industry to curve safely in Maine. From an economic development perspective, the mining industry would be very beneficial to Aroostook County from the aspects of regional investment, higher paying jobs, workforce attraction, retention, support of existing businesses, and generating additional tax revenues. Initial estimates are more than $800 million to develop Ball Mountain, of which $110 million would be invested in water treatment plant. Mining jobs would increase our regional wages. Pay estimates range from $40,000 to over $50,000 versus our current per capita income of $36,800. Running our economic model, which I've given you a copy of, and using a conservative 200 workforce figure, the resulting economic impact would be close to $30 million a year increase in county's GDP. And as the model shows, 200 new jobs would bring 172 indirect and induced jobs as well. The Ball Mountain project is estimated to bring $121 million in tax revenue for the state. Mining projects would require hiring of mining experts from outside the state, which would bring new families to Aroostook to increase our population, buy homes, pay taxes, and send our kids to our schools. Mining jobs would help labor retention by adding employment diversity to our area that is predominantly forestry, agriculture, healthcare, and manufacturing today. It would also bring new support businesses to Aroostook, germane to the industry's unique technology and equipment. Aroostook Partnership strongly believe that balance is needed. We believe that Maine can have a mining operation and continue to protect the environment. And just a word on demographics, we've got about 67,000 people in the county. We're losing 1,200 to 2,000 people every 5 years. It's projected 2035 we'll have about 55,000 people. That in between 2015 and 2025, we'll lose 7,000 taxpayers. I'm worried about our economic base, and I would really strongly encourage you to pass LD 580 or some hybrid with 395, 580 that protects Maine's natural environment but allows this industry to be conducted safely in the state. Thank you.
Thank you. Questions ready?
Good morning. Good
morning.
I'm Jim Gerritsen. My family and I have had a farm in the unorganized territory of Central Aroostook County for 40 years. We raise Maine certified seed potatoes. Our family is opposed to the weakening of Maine's mining regulations, and therefore we are opposed to LD 395. Additionally, we do support LD 820. Because Maine has a wet climate, Maine is absolutely unsuitable for open pit mining. It would be a predictable disaster that the environment would be irreparably harmed from leaching of contaminants such as arsenic and sulfuric acid if an open pit mine were to be allowed on Bald Mountain. As potato farmers, we are keenly aware of changes occurring in the weather patterns, particularly over the last 15 years. Compared to the weather of 30 and 40 years ago, we are now much more likely to experience severe and extended rain events. In areas like Bald Mountain, located about 40 miles northwest of our farm, and Maple Mountain, located about 5 miles west of our farm, the risk of catastrophic failure from a breach in the tailings containment due to an extreme rain event is unacceptably high. So I'd like to make reference to page 2 of the testimony. I've got a map here from NRCM where we plotted in where our farm is located, and you can see the proximity to Maple Mountain and the sulfide deposit there. Additionally, on page 3, I'd like to reference some statistics that I put together from NOAA, which substantiates the idea that there is increased higher levels of precipitation in recent years. And I'd direct your comments or my comments to you to look at 2011 and 2012. 2011 was one of the wettest production years that we have had for generations in Aroostook County. It was wet through planting. By the time we got done planting in mid-June, we received 10 inches of rain over the next 7 days after we got done planting. The next year, 2012, was a relatively dry year, and June didn't have that much rain, but we received in our town near Bridgewater, we received 10 inches of rain over 3 days, the last 3 days of June. And at the same time, caribou, as you can see on this chart indicates that they received the record amount of 6.97. So four of the wettest Junes ever recorded since weather records began in 1939 occurred in a five-year period this last decade. My point is, when you have tailings containments and you're getting substantial rain events of 5-10 inches, I am not convinced that the mining company is going to adequately prevent a spill, and the effect would be catastrophic. So I'm asking the committee to do the right thing, oppose 395 and support 820.
Questions? Thank you. You should have sent some of that rain down to us last year.
I think that's part of it, is that we're now getting these extreme and stubborn patterns. So if you look at 2011, where the ground was already saturated from previous rains, and then you get 10 inches on top of that, I really don't have confidence that the DEP is adequately looking at this, and the potential for catastrophe is just too high to allow it.
Thank you.
Thank you. My name's Frank Allen, and I'm opposed to LD 395. I'm from Mars Hill, and I'm a lifelong Aroostook County resident. My family's been living in the county for more than 150 years. We've been in Maine for a lot longer, and my family currently owns a camp in Ashland that's about an hour's drive east of Bald Mountain, that we've owned for more than 50 years. So I oppose LD 395 because the risk of changing the mining rules poses to our natural resources, including but not limited to our water sources.
Thank you. I just forgot to start the clock. You've done very well.
Short and sweet.
Thank you for saving my life. Any questions? Before you go, wait, just make sure. I don't think so, but thank you very much.
My name is Betsy Bishop Terrell. I speak. My family's owned camps on Carr Pond since 1902, which is about 2 miles from Bald Mountain. I am in support of LD 253, the act to repeal the Maine Mineral Mining Act. LD 254, the act to implement a moratorium on metallic mining, and LD 685, the act to establish a mining advisory panel. Water, one of the most precious resources on Earth. It's vital for all forms of life and for a healthy environment. Over the last 4 years, I've learned about the hazards of metallic mining in an environment with wet soils like we have in Maine. I'm concerned about the following four mining impacts on water quality. Acid mine drainage. The acid will leach from the rock as long as the source of rock is exposed to air and water, and until the sulfides are leached out, a process that can last hundreds, even thousands of years. Heavy metal contamination and leaching. Heavy metal pollution is caused when such metals such as arsenic, cobalt, copper, cadmium, lead, silver, and zinc contained in excavated rock are exposed to an underground mine come in contact with water. Processing chemical pollution. This kind of pollution occurs when chemical agents such as cyanide or sulfuric acid used by mining companies to separate the target mineral from ore spill, leak, or leach from the mine site into nearby water bodies. These chemicals can be highly toxic to humans and wildlife. Erosion and sedimentation. Mineral development disturbs soil and rock in the course of constructing and maintaining roads, open pits, and waste impoundments. In the absence of adequate prevention and control strategies, erosion of the exposed earth may carry substantial amounts of sediment into streams, rivers, and lakes. Excessive sediment can clog riverbeds and smother watershed vegetation, wildlife habitat, and aquatic organisms. Mining can also deplete surface groundwater supplies. Groundwater withdrawals may damage or destroy streamside habitats many miles from the actual mine site. For the sake of current and future generations, we need to safeguard the purity and quantity of our water against irresponsible mineral development. We need to recognize that in some places, mining should not be allowed to proceed because the identified risks to our resources, such as water, are too great. Maine is such an example of that place. I believe that LD 253, LD 254, and LD 685 are the simplest and least risky approach for solving this problem. Now is the time to protect the waters of Maine. Thank you.
Thank you.
My name is Craig Terrell, and I'm here in opposition of LD 395, LD 820, LD 580, and LD 160. My reasoning I will explain. I'm here as a witness. I have property in T13R8, and I've been directly affected by the exploration that's taking place at Bald Mountain, 2 miles downstream. Fed by Bishop Brook, Moose Brook, Mud Pond Brook, and a myriad of cold springs, during the exploration of Bald Mountain, Black Ledge Mining Company set up holding ponds designed to hold the sludge from the drilling and allow the sedimentation to separate and out and protect the watersheds. Though it looked good on paper, it did nothing to protect Carr Pond from the sedimentation that would flow into Carr Pond. Drilling holes, 500 holes into Bald Mountain resulted in a drawdown of Moose Brook beyond their expectations. And as submitted in the testimony during the LD 1853's hearing, a flow of silt into Carr Pond beyond what was expected from recorded from silt meters and Moose Brook. A driller from Blackhawk Mining Company noted a substantial flow found 200 feet down in fractured bedrock, and he drew a conclusion a full hydraulic report should be required prior to exploration. In hindsight, we can clearly see this should have never been allowed and a more protective requirement in place. I stand in opposition to all mining bills that would allow the contamination of waters in Maine. I'm in support of the repeal and replacement of the 2011 late filed co-authored by the landowners that have thrust us into a never-ending downward spiral towards acceptance of degradation of the waters of Maine. In support of LD 253, 254, and LD 685, a repeal is needed. The Metallic Mining Act lowers the environmental standard set for metallic mining than any other development. A moratorium would ensure that no mining permits were given until these rules were straightened out. And we've worked 5 years diligently, and I've been here for each of them, to try to guide as best we can as citizens towards a better environment. And I hope you'll take this time to do what's right. If you knew there was a way to not allow contamination and pollution of your neighbor's water supply, would you choose to? You have that choice, and you make it for the entire population of Maine. Make the right choice.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good morning, Senator Saviello, and Representative Tucker, and members of the committee. I wrote a letter here. I'm going to try and speak off the cuff a little bit more than read my letter. I run a lodge in northern Maine, about 22 miles south of Bald Mountain. I employ 5 people full-time at the lodge and an additional 5 or so people part-time through the summer. We've been doing this for the last 22 years. And before that, I spent a lot of time in the North Maine woods. I've been in the North Maine woods long enough to see clear cuts and cut forests and, you know, occasionally what looks like some pretty hard use of the land that way. And I've been there long enough to see that land grow back into a forest. And I'm now convinced that that use of the land is a sustainable management practice. It's been a decent living for myself and a great living for the people I employ. And I would hope that that would be an avenue that would be encouraged by the state to explore these practices that don't utilize the resource in a unrecoverable way. If we go in there and we take apart Bald Mountain, that's going to be a one-shot deal. No one's coming back there to go after Bald Mountain again in 20 years or 50 years or whatever. When a forester goes in there and cuts wood, if that's a long-term manager, that forester is going to cut that wood in a way that when he comes back in 20 years or 50 years, there's still going to be a good reason to come back. This Bald Mountain thing is a one-shot deal, and as I've heard before, the way these mining companies, to make their profit, they will have to mitigate their risk and minimize their risk. And that's where I'm worried that that pressure is going to be too much for us to hold back. I got 5 seconds. I just want to say that our little business, trickle-down theory and everything, brings in quite a bit of money to the state of Maine. And if you factor in my little business and all the other little businesses of the state of Maine that support that are supported by our natural resources, that is a big, big basket. And you're weighing a little tiny egg of a Bald Mountain project against that. Thank you very much.
Questions?
Please.
Yes, Representative.
Thank you, Senator. It's not really a question, it's an apology. I had my laptop open a moment ago to see if I'd put your birding weekend up on my website yet, and I haven't. So I apologize. It'll be up by dark.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
thank you very much.
We'll fine him $5 for that.
$5.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
I have Linda Raymond.